So we've got an infinite series here, negative 1 to the n plus 1 over the square root of n. And I always like to visualize this a little bit more, expand it out. So when n equals 1, the first term is negative 1 to the second power, so it's going to be positive. It's going to be 1 over 1, so it's 1. We go minus 1 over the square root of 2, plus 1 over the square root of 3, minus 1 over the square root of 4, and then plus, minus, and we just go on and on and on forever. Now, when we've looked at convergence tests for infinite series, we saw things like this. This passes the alternating series test. And so we know that this converges. Let's say it converges to some value s. But what we're concerned about in this video is not whether or not this converges, but estimating what this actually converges to. We know that we can estimate this by taking a partial sum. Let's say s sub k, this is the first k terms right over here, and then you're going to have a remainder. So plus the remainder after you've taken the first k term. So this actually starts with the k plus first term. And so what I'm concerned about, or what I want to figure out is, what's the minimum number of terms? What's the minimum k here so that my remainder, so that the absolute value of my remainder is less than or equal to 0.001. And I encourage you to pause the video based on what we've seen in previous alternating series estimation situations to see if you can figure this out. All right, I'm assuming you've had a go at it. So let's just remind ourselves what r sub k looks like. So r sub k is going to be, it's going to start with the k plus first term. So it's going to be negative 1, k plus 1 plus 1, so it's negative 1 to the k plus 2 over the square root of k plus 1. And then the next term, I could just write plus negative 1 to the k plus 3 over the square root of k plus 2. And it's just going to go on and on and on like that. Now what we know already, or what we've seen an example of, and we'll verify, or at least get a conceptual verification for us at the end of this video, is, well, the absolute value of this entire sum, the absolute value of this entire sum, is going to be less than the absolute value of the first term. So let me write that down. The absolute value of this entire sum, of this entire remainder, r sub k. And this is, you know, some people refer to this to as kind of the alternating series remainder property, or whatever you want to call it. But the absolute value of this entire thing is going to be less than or equal to the absolute value of the first term, negative 1 to the k plus 2 over the square root of k plus 1. And of course, we want that to be less than 1,000th. So less than, that needs to be less than or equal to 0.001. And so now if this setup right over here inspires you, I once again encourage you to pause the video and see if you can figure out what is the minimum k, what is the minimum k that satisfies this inequality? Well, once again, I'm assuming you've had a go at it. And the key realization here is that this negative 1 to the k plus 2, this makes this whole thing either positive or negative. The denominator is going to be positive for, well, it's definitely going to be positive for all the k's, frankly, for which this the principal root is going to be defined. But we obviously, these are all positive k's as well. So the numerator here just flips the sign. We flip between negative 1 or positive 1, negative 1 or positive 1. But if we take the absolute value, then we know whether it's negative or positive, it's going to end up being positive. So this thing on the left-hand side, that's the same thing as just 1 over the square root of k plus 1, and then that's going to be less than or equal to, that needs to be less than or equal to 0.001. And now we have to just solve this inequality, find out which k's satisfy this inequality. And so let's see, we can multiply both sides by the square root of k plus 1. So square root of k plus 1, so we can get this out of the denominator. And let's actually multiply both sides times 1,000, because this is 1,000th, and so we'll end up with a 1 on the right-hand side. So times 1,000 times 1,000. And what we're going to be left with is, these cancel out. On the left-hand side, we don't have to flip the sign, because we just multiplied by positive things. So we have 1,000 is less than or equal to the square root of k plus 1. We can square both sides, and we get 1 million. 1 million is less than or equal to k plus 1. And then we can just subtract 1 from both sides, and we have 999,999 is going to be less than or equal to k. So k just has to be greater than or equal to 999,999. And remember, we want the smallest k that satisfies these conditions. So the smallest k, if k has to be greater than or equal to this, the smallest k that satisfies this is k is equal to 999,999. So let's write that down. So the smallest k for which this is true is going to be k is equal to 999,999. Now let's convince ourselves that that remainder, that the absolute value of the remainder is definitely going to be less. Is definitely, if we take the partial sum of the first 999,999 terms, that this remainder is actually going to be less than this. I'm telling you, so far we've just kind of worked from the premise that it will be, but let's actually look at that and feel good about it. And once again, I encourage you to pause the video and try it on your own. So let's just rewrite this again, but I'm gonna expand out r sub k. So we're saying that it's all gonna converge to s. And we're going to take the partial sum, the partial sum of the first 999,999 terms, and we're claiming that this is going to be within 1/1000th of this right over here. So this is going to be plus, and so the first term is going to be the remainder of r sub k is going to be our millionth term, and so. The millionth term, we just have to remind ourselves, it's going to be negative 1 to the million and 1th power. So negative 1 to the millionth and 1 power, that's going to be negative 1, because that's an odd number. So it's going to be negative 1 over the square root of a million. So actually, let me do it like this. So it's going to be minus 1 over the square root of a million. And then the next term is going to be plus 1 over the square root of a million and 1. And it's positive now because this is going to be negative 1 to the million and 2nd power. And then it's going to be minus 1 over the square root of 1 million and 2. And then plus, I'll just do two more terms, 1 over the square root of a million and 3, and then minus 1 over the square root of 1,000,004, and then plus minus, it just keeps going on and on, on and on and on forever. Now, I want to convince ourselves that this thing is going to be, the absolute value of this thing is going to be less than 1,000th. It's going to be essentially less than the absolute value of this first term. So how do we think about it? So this first term, we already know, this first term right over here is negative 0.001, because it's 1 over 1,000, and we have this negative right over here. Now, the first thing we could realize, if we just put parentheses like this, we see that this is going to be positive. This term is larger than this term. This term is larger than this term. And we could keep going. So we're going to have the remainder kind of starts at negative 1,000th, and then it just adds a bunch of positive terms. So it's not going to get any more negative than this. So we know that the remainder can't get more negative than this, but let's also verify that it can't, you know, get more than a positive 1,000th either. And the way that we can do that is to just look at the parentheses in a different way. If we do it this way, this is going to be a negative value. This right over here is going to be a negative value, and we can just keep, so we could say plus that, plus that. And so we're going to have a bunch of negative values together. So just like that, we by really looking at the parentheses a little bit differently, we're able to say this is definitely going to be negative. This remainder is definitely going to be a negative value, but it can't be any more negative than our first term. So that tells us that our remainder is not going to get any the absolute value of the remainder can't get any larger than 1,000. We're not going to, as we add more and more and more terms here, we're not going to get any further away from the actual sum than we were, than the first term.